I'm Dr. Rishikesh Venkatraman, currently an associate professor and head of the IT systems at IIIT Sri City, that's Indian Institute of Information Technology. I'm here as an invited speaker to give a lecture on multi-hop communication for 5G wireless systems. Now, what is 5G? Today, as we move towards cellular evolution, we have moved from 2G to 3G to almost 4G, where Reliance is, in India, is offering currently 4G services, but based on LTE, that's long-term evolution. Now, if you actually see, our mobile revolution does not end with 4G or LTE. This is just the beginning, and what we will see in the coming times is that there will be beyond 4G, that is B4G, comprising of 5G and then 6G and so on. But what would be the most important point to note is that unlike the movement from 2G to 3G or 3G to 4G, where 3G was mainly on CDMA and 4G's underlying principle is based on OFDM, the LTE or the current 4G standards will remain as it is. And what will be coming as B4G or beyond 4G is something that will be over and above the current LTE standards. This includes something like multi-hop, that is a communication mechanism wherein a mobile phone, in this case a mobile phone, will not only directly communicate with the base station, but will also have the ability to act as a relay node. Or to put it in simple terms, it will be a very micro or a nano form of a base station where it will enable some other mobile phones to communicate with the destination, thereby acting as more an intermediate or a relay node. Now, what is it that multi-hop can give? Such a multi-hop communication mechanism can actually increase the coverage. For example, today we typically see that I always, as a user, many times I'm in a region where there is a coverage hole or a dead zone, where there is no ability to reach the base station. Such a situation, this multi-hop communication mechanism will enable a phone to actually communicate with somebody, a nearby user equipment or a nearby device, which in turn will take the data of this particular phone and transmit it to the base station. The second most important point of this multi-hop communication mechanism is the overall increase in the throughput. Now, if we actually see, we have really moved on from an era where we were talking of voice-based communication requiring kilobits data rate to a lot of database communication, where we talk of YouTube, WhatsApp videos, Facebook videos, which needs tens and hundreds of MBPS. Which typically cannot be covered even with a simple LTE system. Today, we are talking of tens of Mbps per second. Tomorrow, we'll be talking of 100 Mbps per second. And soon, we will have a data rate of 1 gigabits per second. Such a system would need much more technologies like multi-hopping, beamforming, cognitive radio, and so on. So this lecture series is focusing on one of the technique, that is the multi-hop communication mechanism. Thank you, and I'm sure this will help them a lot.